Hello, this is Gabriel, and just gonna go over my setup for Tarmac. I'm pretty much using this for Monte Carlo and for Germany, and it's for the Ford Fiesta, although, you know, the 2010 cars and any car class, to be honest, this all kind of applies, to be honest. You know, it's all pretty interchangeable kind of logic. So, brake bias I put on the front because I'd rather be braking only on corner entry in a straight line. Maybe a little bit in the corner, but if you can stay off of it in the corner, that's quite nice. You know, keep it smooth and not have to like adjust your angle, you know. So racing more like we're on a track, that's quite nice. Quite high brake strength because we're on tarmac and we've got, you know, Michelins basically on tarmac, and we've got a lot of traction there that can handle the brakes. Play around with that, I would, because basically the stronger you go, the later you brake, and that's just faster. Diff, fairly neutral diff, really. There's probably a lot of optimization I could do here. I mean, there is all over the place, but yeah, I mean, I wanted it quite balanced, so on tarmac, I found for me, if I put a bit too much power down and brake traction, whichever way my diff is set, if it's more towards the back, then I will just oversteer and kill myself, or if it's more towards the front, I just drive into a tree. So I went for quite a sort of balanced one with a slight loose preference on the rear just for better cornering, basically. But play around with it, you know. You want to be able to kind of put some power down in corners without oversteering or understeering too much. You don't really want to be oversteering like you do, you know, on gravel when you're going around a corner on tarmac, because you're just going to lose your car. You really are. On tarmac, you know, the smallest amount of unaccounted for oversteer or understeer can really just send you off the fucking road. So yeah, watch out for that. Gears, I prefer them a bit longer or sort of more mid on tarmac, just so I don't like wheel spin and lose the car. Because if you're trying to put, you know, if you've got a lot of acceleration and you mash the throttle down, then you might just break traction and die. And that's where those diff, you know, your diff will decide if you understeer into something in front of you or oversteer and end up in, you know, a spectator, basically. Suspension, we're on tarmac, got to be pretty firm. Ride height should probably be pretty low. I swear something's changed my setups. These things seem to change on their own. Spring rate and tender, that's because, you know, they're like that because I've stiffened the suspension so much, and that's good. Anti-roll bar, you don't want to roll, basically. As you go around a corner, you don't want too much of the weight going anywhere, really, because the more it goes to the outside of the car as you're turning, the more likely you are to lose the car, and, you know, you're just not going to be able to carry as much speed on the corner exit, and all sorts of reasons. You just don't want too much weight being transferred to the outer tyres. You want a nice sort of even spread. Camber angle, if you think of it this way, negative camber angle improves cornering and makes it just easier. And then toe angle makes your car kind of turn better. This is difficult to explain. So camber angle kind of keeps your car in check. It stops it from going too sideways. And trust me, you'll feel, if you put a load of negative camber angle on and then drive around a corner, you'll feel the difference. Toe angle kind of makes it so that you can use all this sort of cornering grip that you gain from having the negative camber angle better, because you can turn in better on the front. On the back, it can reduce it understeer, may cause oversteer. That's fine. Understeer is a bad thing, you know. It's always bad. A little oversteer can be sort of okay, you know. Just watch like how twitchy your inputs are if you do start to oversteer, because you just kind of want to let it run with it if you do oversteer a bit. And dampers kind of depends on the rally, but yeah, definitely more firm, basically. Again, play around with that, see what feels good for you, and that's about it. So yeah, some things that you might think about to really optimise a tarmac setup is brake strength, diff, figuring out sort of how short to mid kind of your gears can be without breaking traction too easily when you dump the gas. Suspension should be quite firm. So, yeah. Oh, sorry. I was talking about optimization. So, camber angle and toe angle. So, camber angle, toe angle, gears, diff, and the brake strength in particular. That's where I think you can make up probably the most time. I know that's kind of like everything, but you know, brake strength in particular. That, you know, as much braking as you can get away with is great. You know, because the later you're braking, the faster you'll be. So I hope this helps, and yeah, thank you very much.